I wanna take things slow, put my mind in cruise control.
Rough Riders,
ah, fuck I'm talking
don't
about
get it
right
twisted,
here.
Y'all.
Kiss over premiere, kill you on tape, then watch it over a beer. Cause you ain't nothing but a movie with expensive footage. That's the reason they gon' leave you with expensive bullets. Ain't none of y'all better than Locks. Have all of y'all dressed up in a suit, dead in a box. Me and my niggas get redder than Fox. Now I don't care if I love you, I still want head in the drop. Niggas running around talking that Y2K shit. Crackheads is still gon' want that gray shit. That's why I'ma always cop the yay quick. So I suggest all of y'all stay off J. Dick. Too hard for MTV, not black enough for BET. Just let me be, give me all my royalty money and let me read. And I'ma have O's for six and halves for three.
Recognize. Rough Riders, don't get it twisted, y'all.
Dang. Are we unmuted?
We're live.
Are we live, Dave?
Yeah.
You sure?
Check, check. Microphone check. Testicles 1-2. Testicles 1-2.
Wow. Jadakiss, he just decided to casually fry a song, I hear. Why would he do that? Why would he do that in such a manner?
Recognize. I was listening to the...
What's that?
The Tiny Desk that the Locks did the other day.
That's right. That's right.
And that was
that's
the first song they played. I was like, ooh, this could be a good
intro song?
Song for the
and
pod.
That it was. It was a great intro song to episode 119 here on the Cruise Control. Ah! You already know what it is. If you can hear me, if you can see me, you're locked
semen.
In with us, baby. Now listen, before you
he's gonna let me say semen randomly.
Yeah. No big deal.
Before you listen to another second, before you watch another minute of the Cruise Control episode, I'm going to need you to do one thing for me. You're going to click the subscribe button. And Benny's great at this, Dave. He does this on the YouTube pages.
Yeah, this guy Benny is pretty cool. He's a pretty swell character.
You're going to click the subscribe button right here, right? And you know how it has that play sign next to it? This time it's going to be a little bit different. This time it's going to be a picture of Dave's face with a can of Pepsi on top of it.
What?
Balancing it on his head.
Then he's gonna keep like raising the stakes on the edit.
Right, as soon as there's no subscribe button, just this ridiculous
it's be
scene
Dave with the body of a snake and the head of a mongoose.
Just do all that.
We'll get there.
But hit that subscribe button, like and comment underneath the video. Everybody who follows us, everybody who puts on the notifications, we appreciate y'all.
Every follow counts, every like, every subscription.
Yes, sir. Yes,
y'all
sir.
Y'all got to know, like, for those of y'all who've been down with us for the longest, that's how you support us. My bad. I had to lick my lips because I just feel that passionate about this.
Liking and subscribing?
Yeah, this is like so sensual to me to talk about liking and subscribing. So please, show us your love. Show us your support.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yo. Yeah, Betty Lassies. Sorry, I had to yawn.
Yo,
in pieces.
I ran that like 3 times while I was listening to the podcast.
Same. I turned the volume all the way up to listen to that stupid yawn you did. But Dev, we here, man.
Man, and
episode
I'm excited, man.
That's crazy.
Episode 119. And for those who don't know, I mean, I do this every episode, but let me just give you a quick introduction to the crew. As you know already, it's your boy, the breast above the rest. Right. Your boy Chess.
He a 69 guy.
What am I?
He a 69 guy.
A what?
He a 69 guy.
Yes, sir.
Ooh, she my man, Simeon.
Sitting to my left, the one and only.
A cannoli is.
Cannoli cruises in the building. How you feeling, big boy? On purpose.
Wow. Right. I'm good.
And messed up his whole move. Came in here marveled out geek time.
I'm good.
He said I'm good.
Big boy. I'm doing great, man. Thank you for asking.
Good. Good. And the man behind the camera, Dave, the one and only, the legend. The streets know who he is.
This is what it sounds like when Benny's eating ice cream.
Why is he eating ice cream that fast?
Llama. So
Bendito's behind the camera. What's up, Benny? How you doing, cuz?
I'm doing great, man.
Chilling? How
are y'all? Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
Another good week for everybody. How we feeling, man? The energy. I need the energy to just get there a little bit more. You know what I'm saying? It is the Cruise Control episode 119.
Yeah, listen.
It had a long week. We looking a little tired. Oh, I know why Dave's tired. You feel me? We got some claps up to do. We got some celebrating to do. Dave, real quick, why don't you know you had a big life update. Why don't you go ahead and let the controllers know what you did, man?
I just want to thank everybody, you know, who showed up and was sent their well wishes, sent me messages, texts, showed love, but
sexed.
Everybody who sent me sex. But I just finished my second master's degree. Got my MBA, so had a little party, a little shindig.
Yes, sir.
Invited some people out, and it was great, man. I had a great time. Shout out to Roz first and foremost
for holding it down.
Putting together a great shindig, mom and pop for hosting, helping putting that together. Mm-hmm. I had a signature cocktail at the party.
What was the signature drink, Dave?
It was called the Cannoli Cruise.
That's fire.
Of course.
That's fire.
That was an amazing feeling. It was an old fashioned, you know, but it had a little cannoli twist on it.
Right.
In that you had to pour it down a cannoli funnel.
How was you at the end of the funnel?
Mouth wide open.
I thought you drank it through a cannoli.
That's freaky.
Like using that's a cannoli crazy. as a cannoli straw
is nuts.
A cannoli straw is freaky. It was a great time. Great time. Just really, really grateful for that. And yeah, you know, I was a little schmiz. I was a little schwiz.
I get it. So a little schwiz. He's got to get the energy back up today. You feel
yeah.
me?
Yeah. I need a perk 30 right now. Perk me up.
Complete opposite of what you need.
You need a perk.
I need a perk 30 and a Red Bull.
It's just gonna be normal. Gonna take a downer.
Wait, a perk is a downer? Yeah, bro.
But why call it perk? It perks you up.
Percocet is the medical.
Yeah, but I know. Dev, you work in a hospital for 20 minutes and now you.
I've been working in a hospital.
Doctor Schachter.
Doctor Schachter.
That's not even a real doctor.
No, it's called a perk. It should perk you up.
Okay.
That's just my feelings. And my feelings are valid on the weekend that I got my master's and celebrated it.
That's true. And it was a good weekend to celebrate. Had food popping, drinks popping. And then, you know, with the Cruise family, we don't just do one thing, right? We like to celebrate a whole weekend. So not only did we have the party for Dave yesterday, had fun time today.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Oh, of course, man. I was in my bag. You feel me? Drinks all on deck. I have five drinks across my arms like this.
Yeah.
And I was just drinking like tank. This.
Drink it through your chest.
Yeah, I got to drink the way. And it gets absorbed into this area. That's why my chest is saggy because it was tired. It's drunk. My nipples are drunk.
Benny unfortunately couldn't join us. You know, right. He had a prior engagement. But did you have a good weekend?
Yeah, weekend was fun. It was a good weekend. Made some money. Coming to terms with the fact that I have a Temu addiction. But outside of that, it was good.
A Temu addiction?
Yeah.
Temu is what?
Is Temu popping off like that for you? What's the latest thing you bought?
I'm getting ready for hoodie season. So I'm getting a couple hoodies on there for cheap, see what the quality looks like.
Oh yeah, if I like John's gonna dissolve in the wash on the first wash.
Probably. But
like cotton candy.
Yeah. I already got like four hoodies in my closet. And I got like three more coming.
On deck.
Temu, yeah.
Yeah, but the other ones I got from like the store.
Limo, Emu.
Target, mall, stuff like that. Also got a Target problem that's happening.
Yeah, this boy got a lot of problems, dude.
Right.
Yeah.
The only prescription is more shopping.
Spending too much money.
They don't sell vape at Target, though.
They don't, but
They sell perks.
They got the perks.
Then he got a perk problem.
They got a perk problem.
That's a crazy thing to admit on the pod.
Nah. No perk problems. But yeah, I've been shopping too much. I got you.
It's all right, bro. Listen.
I knew you had a problem because when he walked into the studio today, mm-hmm. he had like four hoodies on. I'm like, what's up with this bull? It's 98 degrees outside. I'm like, damn, what's
this? Yo, but like,
I got a problem.
Once my birthday passed in July, I'm just ready for the fall. I don't care about the rest
of
the
summer. Yeah. Mentally, you go right to the fall. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hoodie season is my favorite. So,
shout out to this boy, man.
I know. I love it.
Hoodie Valentine.
I love it. Shout out to Benny.
Say Hoodie Valentine.
Shout out to Benny, man. Shout out to Dave for.
Yeah, congrats, Dave.
For grabbing that. Great. Grabbing his masters, man.
Paul was a genius. Spell masters.
Thank you. I'm not your little puppet.
Your ventriloquist.
No, I know how to spell masters.
No, we know that. We know that.
I taught y'all how to spell Couth last week.
Sure.
And I still got it wrong.
And you still got it wrong.
You said couch.
Where's the couch?
On the YouTube edit. But where's the couch?
My
Your
bad,
brain yo. Reverted to the easier word.
But nah, listen, man. Not only this week did we have a party for Dave for celebration, but we took this guy out to see a movie as a family. You feel me? And we saw Marvel's latest hit, Deadpool. Was it Deadpool versus Wolverine or Deadpool and Wolverine?
I think either or is fine.
Either or is fine, but the Deadpool Wolverine movie.
Tomato, tomato.
Yeah.
Timu, Tamu.
We saw that.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we could talk about it. You want to do a spoilers-free episode, or do we want to say spoilers and then have people skip 15, 20 minutes ahead if they don't want
to
hear
it? It's been out a week?
2 weeks.
2 weeks?
I think it's 2 weeks. I seen it last.
It just came out last weekend, right?
Yeah.
So 1 week. Last weekend, this weekend.
Yeah, I guess 1 week. Yeah.
A week and some change by the time the episode comes out.
Yeah.
Spoiler full.
Yeah.
Okay. So skip, you know how we do our segments.
If you haven't.
15, 20 minutes. If you want to skip this part.
Yes. If you haven't watched Deadpool versus Wolverine, go ahead and skip. But I don't feel like I know some places do. Oh, spoiler free. Why? For what? If I'm trying to avoid spoilers, guess what I'm going to do? Skip. Or just turn that episode off and come back to it.
Yeah, we're giving you a little heads up now. So if you haven't seen it, go see it. But we are going to talk about it. So skip 15, 20 minutes ahead.
Yeah.
And you'll be fine.
Just if you haven't watched it yet, fast forward to the point where I'm talking about my meat. You'll know that we're past the spoilers. Yeah,
and it's a little conversation.
I'll put a time stamp.
Yeah, put a meat stamp.
I'll put a meat stamp.
A meat stamp is crazy.
It'll be in fine, small print.
Fast forward. As soon as you hear meat... Is a meat stamp, you know, you can listen on past that safely.
So Deadpool versus Wolverine came out last weekend.
A lot of anticipation for this movie, Dev.
Very much.
You know, everybody knows here that we're straight up dorks. Look at my hat.
Yeah, the hat Avengers with the shirt. Hat,
X-Men shirt.
Matching. Look, Devin, man. Got
Pokemon all over his body. We love this stuff. We love this stuff. I'm a big Marvel fan. I think, Benny, you are too, right?
Yeah, yeah, same here.
Dev. You be frauding if we could be real for a moment.
Listen.
Just
this boy go to the movie on his phone.
I was on my phone.
The screen's like, don't spoil the movie by adding your own soundtrack.
But I was on my phone.
Dev's adding his own soundtrack.
I was on my phone at that point. And then when the movie started, I turned my phone off. But I didn't spoil the movie. I turned my phone off. All right, so that's it. He be mad because, look, my family, they take these Marvel movies to the next level, which is,
let's be more specific, it's Pop.
No, and you and Davi.
But I be chilling.
They be going on YouTube and stuff and looking at the bull, right? It be some fat bull sitting behind a thousand comics. He got glasses on and a Hulk tie, and he's like, hello, this is Marvel Man 2127, and I'm back here with another 10 spoilers you didn't see in the Marvel movie. That's them. That's what they be watching.
Yeah.
So then they come into the movie tough. Like, that's Venom's tongue right there. It got cut off in the Star Wars. I'm like, what? Who cares? Like, just watch the movie with me. But that's what, and they don't think because I don't do that.
Hater.
They think because I don't do that, that I'm not a Marvel fan. But I'm a Marvel fan. I find it interesting. I follow the storyline. I follow the plot. I just don't like the extras because I'd be surprised in the movie. Like, I'll just go.
But it's also levels even within the family. Because Pop.
Yeah, Pop is like.
This is a religion to him to watch a Marvel movie.
Let me give you an example of how serious Pop takes his movie. Let me give you an example from today, from the movie. So where the movie started at a certain time, we're all running like, say, like 5 minutes behind, right? We all drove separately. So Davi gets there, mom and pop get there. Mom calls me. She's like, where you at? I'm like a couple minutes away. I'm right down the block. All right, because your dad just ran into the movie because they wasn't trying to let us in. And he argued with the boy up front to let him into the movie early so he could see the beginning credits.
Pop, he does not want to miss previews. That's his thing.
Yo, I'm the same way.
He's like, I can't miss a single preview. So we had we had bought our tickets together in one transaction. Pop was like, so they showed up and the guy's like, well, you can't go in until your whole party's here. And Pop was just arguing with this boy. I don't know why them ticket people take themselves so seriously at the theater. That's a whole nother conversation. Because like we clearly pay for the ticket. It's right here. Yeah. You can scan it twice. But apparently Pop had a back and forth with this guy just to make sure he was in his seat for right when them previews started.
Pop said, you can let me in or one of us is leaving with a black eye today. That's what
he said. He put a threat on that man's life. Let me in. Just some boy in a wheelchair.
I was trying to get touched his face. I'm dying tonight. What are you doing?
I'm saying.
But he takes it very seriously. But I'll be honest though. You watch that stuff too. Daviana does too. They'll have talks at the dinner table when we come together. Like, yeah, I was watching, you know, Marvel Man 2728, and he said this, and oh yeah, I watched that too. And did you see the episode? And I'm not like that. So when they talk, I'm just like on my phone, like my mouth is open, like, just while listening, like whatever.
Oh, you're still explaining why you was on your phone?
No. Well, the whole point is that just because they take this more seriously than me does not make me a lesser Marvel fan. That's all I'm trying to say. Because he tried to clown me in the beginning, right? Let's get real, Dev. You're not a Marvel fan. You iffy. You're on your phone. No, I like the movie. I like to be surprised. I like to talk about it with my family afterwards, not a bull on YouTube.
All right, fine. Now let's talk about it then.
So let's get it working. This movie was garbage.
See? Yeah, that's another no Dev-ism, right?
Yeah. Nah. There's no way.
We're 119 episodes in. Everything is garbage to Dev.
Nah, yeah. I'm joking.
Except Kendrick.
I'm joking.
And
Right. If Kendrick was in a Marvel movie, Dev'd be like, oh, that'd
movie probably
was
be
tough.
Movie of the year. Like, no. Nah, but
pure suckage, yo.
On some real though, the movie I felt was the best out of the Deadpools. This is my opinion. I'll go first and open up the conversation. Best out of the Deadpools movie. I was never a fan of the Deadpool movies because it seemed to be centered too much around like Ryan Reynolds, and like a movie is not based off of one character. You're like, yeah, it's the Deadpool movies, but you need a good cast to let the movie go forward and have that longevity. Like Guardians of the Galaxy, right? It started off with Peter Quill, but when you added in the other characters, it became a great movie. And I feel like that's where Deadpool always fell short, was like he did too much trying to make it funny and fourth wall and throwing too many jokes in there that you really only paid attention to his character. When in reality, he needs the backup characters to be good. So when you get to this third movie and they start introducing all this stuff and all these extra people and all these, I'm like, I don't care. Like, I didn't care for it. This seemed like a bunch of fanfare to me, this movie.
Oh, it was a total fan service.
Which I was cool with.
Yeah.
I was cool with. This is the one movie that I didn't like the plot, but I liked the movie because of the fanfare. Like, I loved it. I loved, we said spoilers, right? I loved Wesley Snipes coming back as Blade. I loved.
Hot with the spoilers.
Yeah. Right.
I didn't say the M word yet. Keep fast forwarding.
Huh?
No, keep going. I'm just saying, still spoilers.
Yeah, it's still spoiler time. Whatchamacallit. Channing Tatum, I thought, was great as Gambit. Like, I thought that was cool. I thought that was a fun character. He was killing it with the action scenes with him.
Yeah.
It was great. I thought that was fun. I thought that was unique. Carmen Electra was weak.
Carmen Electra?
Whatever her name is.
Just Electra, man.
Yeah. Who was Carmen? That's an actual actress,
Carmen,
right?
Carmen Electra, yeah. She's like a model from the 90s.
But Electra was weak. Like, she was weak. She got the Raphael from the Ninja Turtle swords. She don't do nothing with them. Like, she don't got no powers or nothing. Wesley Snipes was fighting zombies or vampires. And she was fighting blind people. Like, her character is so weak.
Yo, Daredevil.
Right.
You feel me? I'm actually really enjoying this breakdown.
But
just to hear you kind of explain the way your brain works.
But yeah, the story, you really didn't have a story. Wolverine was tough, though. I won't hold you. Hugh Jackman was tough as Wolverine. I always thought he was a good Wolverine character. too many like mute, like you, I love music, but man, the, what was the music expense on this movie? Like, it was like every hit song from the 90s blasted at 100 level, like at level 100, just blasted in my ear. Like, I don't want to hear Backstreet Boys while you stabbing somebody in the throat, like for the 50th time in the movie. Like, every long scene in the movie, they needed a song to make it.
But bearable. That's a part of the aesthetic of Deadpool.
Yeah, I agree.
But that's what I'm saying. I feel like that's cheap as a movie to have a scene that's bullcrap, like them driving in the car for 5 minutes. But as long as it has, you know, Madonna playing in the background, it's cool because you can listen to a song while they're driving for 5 minutes straight and not doing anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's corny. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, no.
Those were the things that I noticed that kind of threw me off when I was watching the movie, though.
Yeah. Go ahead, Benny. I want to hear what you have to say about it.
I thought it was one of the best things Marvel put out in a long time.
Mm.
I enjoy the character, what a life Ryan Reynolds brings to Deadpool.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's supposed to be all those things that Dev didn't like obnoxious, super loud, super talkative, mm-hmm. breaking the fourth wall, mm-hmm. like the comedic relief
mm-hmm.
out of all the seriousness that Marvel brings to the table. I thought it was great. A lot of action. They bounced around through different timelines, but didn't make it confusing.
Mm.
That was dope. I liked the whole scenes where he was going to try to find a Wolverine that would help him. And the comic book size one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the act, because he's like 5'3" in the comics.
Yeah.
That was actually.
He pulled up. That was pretty funny. And I'm kind of like the way Dave is. Like, after I watched the movie, I went and found his YouTube video. And this boy did like an hour and 11 minute long video about all the spoilers and Easter eggs inside the film. So I watched that whole thing after the movie was done. I was super excited. I bought Deadpool Funko Pops of Dogpool.
Timu.
Nah, they weren't from Timu. They were the Funko website. But it's another addiction we'll talk about later.
I got a Funko problem.
I got a Funko problem. It's crazy.
All problem work for Benny.
I got 386 Funkos.
No, I'm kidding. Oh, I was about to say, I would believe you too.
No, it was great, man. A lot of action. Hugh Jackman is getting old for the role, but he held his own there.
Yo, Hugh Jackman is a crazy name. Pure porn star name.
Yeah.
Hugh Jackman.
Jackman. But I thought it was great, man. I did love seeing Wesley Snipes in there. I hope they bring him back for one more Blade movie, even though he's ancient now. I think it would be tough.
Yeah, he was skinny.
Super skinny.
He said it in the movie, though, right? Then he said, like, I'm the only one to ever play or ever will play Blade. And then Ryan Reynolds winked at the camera.
Said there will only ever be one Blade. There is another Blade out there.
But isn't that...
No, Reynolds looked at the camera like, we'll see, because they have the other Blade.
I thought that got... Somebody told me that got cut.
No, it's still...
That Blade...
Apparently, it's still in the works. It's just been going through a lot with Mahershala Ali.
Mahershala Ali.
Yeah, I don't know, boy.
He's a good actor. He's a good actor.
He's not Blade, though.
Let him try.
He can be Ali, but he can't be Blade.
What you think? What you think, Dave? I know you got a lot to say.
His name is Ali.
I know you got a lot to say. What did the boy on the TV say to you the other day?
Nothing. I didn't watch. I tried to avoid spoilers. Like, I actually did a pretty good job of avoiding spoilers, firstly. But I thought it was cool. It was a really good action movie. At the same time, I did not know what I left the theater, like how it contributed to the MCU. But I think I have a take on that I'll share in a second about where this whole saga stands with the multiverse and all that. For those people listening who are fans of Marvel and try to follow that as well. But now, just to go back to the movie for a second. Yeah, I thought it was a good action movie. A lot of good action sequences. There was definitely fan service with all the cameos and things. And sometimes you do just want like a funny movie. Like, I laughed several times throughout the movie.
Yeah.
At different parts or different jokes. So that was cool. I remember one of the jokes that stuck out to us was when he met, was it Nice Pool?
Yeah.
Which was like a nicer version of him as Ryan Reynolds or whatever in the Deadpool costume. And he was like, oh, I could break the fourth wall too. And he just looked at the camera and he was like, the proposal.
Yeah, that was funny.
Such a dumb name drop. That movie was tough though. Shout out to Sandra Bullock.
That was hilarious. And she had the juggas on.
Dev, what's up with you, dude?
Sandra Bullock was caked out in that jungle. Hold you. Shout out to her.
But go ahead. What is your definition of cake?
You didn't think in the movie? If I remember correctly,
Sandra Bullock's like, she's pretty or whatever.
But that movie
you gotta slow down. You really have to like tweak your language. You call your white friends your homies. You be saying Sandra Bullock is caked up, yeeked up, whatever you just said.
He said the juggas.
The juggas.
I need a
Have you even seen a thick John like in your life?
Continue, keep talking.
Look, spoiling the movie by adding his own soundtrack.
Damn.
On the phone.
I'm letting you talk. I'm letting you get your. Go ahead. It seems to behoove him.
He's asking you a question.
Yeah, this is a podcast. This is a back and forth.
Yeah,
and I'm talking to you, and I'm trying to give an intervention to tell you to calm it down.
You see, he's getting his voice all loud. I'm about to uppercut him like the boy in that podcast. Like, cool it down. Because
I think Benny and I would agree that you have a problem.
Why are you screaming at me? Benny, would you agree?
I would agree.
It's a disrespect to the definition of juggas, right?
Right. Dang. First of all, I need a definition of juggas. Because I want to know what you think juggas are.
Nah, what is a jugger?
To be honest,
spell juggas.
One of my friends uses that towards, like, says that to me when he sees a girl with, like, big boobs. So he calls them juggas. So I'd used it as a shout out to him. He listens to the pod every episode.
He's one of your homies?
He's a black guy, if you're curious.
So he's a friend.
Yeah.
But your white friends are your homies. Well, like, what type of bizarre world are you living in,
Dad? You just screamed at me.
This whole pod is backwards.
For saying homies, so I'm just going to start calling it. I'm going to call people acquaintances from here on out. My man, I'm going to just start calling people acquaintances from here on out. That's it.
Look, we got them all in his family. Yeah.
Just to get Dave happy.
So anyway.
No, go ahead, Dave.
Sandra Bullock with the juggas.
There it is.
That's the name of the episode. I thought it was a good movie. I thought it was like action packed.
Mm-hmm.
I said this before. Did I say this on the pod before? But I just never. I always felt that Hugh Jackman is hilarious. He's a great actor. I still don't think he's the prototypical Wolverine. He's given a lot to the role, and he acts. What he's a good actor.
Yeah.
I just visually. I just never seen it, and in this one, I still don't necessarily see. That he's the best Wolverine. Also, spoiler, when they did the Henry Cavill Wolverine,
that was tough.
I was like, that could be the Wolverine that could like take it for the next couple years.
But if you're gonna say that what happened to Wesley Snipes, it's the same thing that happened to him, Hugh Jackman.
Wesley Snipes is a legend. He's tough.
No,
when Blade showed up, I was like, that's Blade right there. And he was holding his own.
Yeah.
But rumbling.
Blade, the issue with Blade is that back in the day, Wesley Snipes, when he was younger, he fit that role well. He was built. He was huskier. He was quicker. Same thing with Wolverine. Back when Hugh Jackman was playing Wolverine back in the day, he was built like that. Now they're both just two skinny older guys who they don't build like a superhero anymore.
I'm going to tell you my problem with the replacement of Blade. You can't put a ball in the role when Blade had the tough, small box cut drawn.
Is it hair that makes
it? It's a big difference.
You could just put a false hair.
Why make him bald then? Give him a wig.
Because that's the
thing. And he had the shape up on the side that was like tough.
Yeah, the cool shape up. Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
He had it in this movie.
Your coof with his haircut.
He lost his coof.
I lost my coof. Blade can't be bald. All right? That's it. I just don't believe it.
Yo, that's hilarious.
That's fair, man.
Shout out to Betty. I didn't know that.
That's literally my biggest problem with it. I didn't know that hair was
a big problem.
It's like, yo, that's Morpheus playing Blade.
Right.
Not Morpheus. That is so not Morpheus, man. Dev, your point about Ryan Reynolds is an interesting one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it did. Come off a little self-centered, just like if you think about where he is as an actor and with the IP of Deadpool, it did seem like he really made the movie centered around everything that Deadpool is. And it so to Dev's point, I would agree that it doesn't help contribute to the story.
Yeah,
because it needs to be about more than just Deadpool's funny. He's quirky.
Mm-hmm.
He says funny quips and breaks the sometimes the movie has to grow to be more than that. Which leads to my biggest point on this is that, yeah, I did leave the theater going, how does this help contribute to the MCU? What I actually think it showed is I think this was Marvel's admission that the multiverse saga is just kind of chalked already. It's like, we know it don't make sense. So we're just going to give, like, we're going to finish out the movies in this saga by just doing things that just kind of don't make sense, but we can do some cool visual things with them on screen. And then we'll reset when we bring the X-Men into the, like, the X-Men and the next saga will be like the full refresh and you'll kind of just redo everything.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I feel that way because, yeah, I left at the end of the movie going, how did this help move anything along? Like, Deadpool finds out about the TVA and multiverses and time travel and all this. Mm-hmm. And yet he didn't do anything to really contribute to it. It was another story of, oh, your timeline's about to be pruned, mm-hmm, or, you know, wiped away, like, save it. And him wanting to be a superhero that's admired. Cool. But that's like another self-contained John. And I think all of us grew to love the MCU because of all the intertwined. Like, everything felt like it was connected in somewhere or another.
Yeah.
So this multiverse thing has really kind of gotten, it's gotten blown out of just where everything is kind of going in different directions, in my opinion. And that's the, I guess, bitter pill to swallow. I think, too, that, you know, to speak briefly to the news that Robert Downey's going to play Doom.
Doctor Doom
kind of replaced Kang as, like, the big bad of this saga. Yeah. Again, it's another testament to, I think, Marvel just was like, we're going to cut our losses. I guess they felt the Kang thing didn't work. But I think the whole multiverse travel, it was centered around Kang being that time-traveling villain.
Yeah.
So now that you don't have that, you're just like, all right, let's try to grab some money with Robert Downey coming back. You know people are going to pack the theaters to watch that, no matter how good that product is, because Robert Downey Jr. is a part of it. It all feels like a big money grab. I'm gonna still go watch.
Yeah, but he's a good actor, though. I mean, he can do it. Yeah.
I just, who wants to, like, I want to see, if I'm going to see Doom, who's a big time villain in comics and in Marvel.
You want to be his own?
I want to see a fresh new character. I don't want to see Robert Downey come back and then I got to understand that it's a variant of him or whatever. Like, that's the whole problem with the multiverse thing. This variant thing, it gives you license to do whatever you want and it just doesn't feel grounded in any way.
Yeah. And what I feel like this whole movie felt that way because it was a commentary on where Marvel's going.
Right.
Right. The movie felt sporadic. It felt like there was no plot. It felt like it was just let's invite all these characters to make fans happy. And that's literally what Marvel's been doing.
Right.
Right. You've just been bringing in these characters who the movie, like, it was such a weak cast of characters, mm-hmm, that Marvel, it wasn't going to be able to stand on those legs of Hawkeye and Captain America and Miss Marvel and them. Like, that was weak. Those characters are weak. She-Hulk. Like, you got to introduce the X-Men, the Fantastic Four. Like, give the people what they've been looking for. Like, and make them a staple. And, like, that's what they're doing. Because as soon as those movies flopped and as soon as those TV shows flopped, what did they announce? They announced the Fantastic Four is coming out and Doctor Doom is going to... Like, they knew it. They were like, we're testing this out. And if it doesn't work, we got to put in a big group of people that we know is going to pack the theaters. And who's that? The Fantastic Four. And we know everybody's going to come to see the Fantastic Four. And then add Robert Downey Jr. to the mix. Oh, this movie's going to be a hit.
Yeah.
And this is different than the other ones because this is a part of the universe. So you know you're going to see these characters for a very long time now, right? Just as the Avengers did. You're going to see the Fantastic Four. They introduce X-Men in the Marvel's movie. You're going to start seeing the X-Men now. Like, you're just going to start seeing this stuff more often. And I think they did that because they realized how bad these TV shows and movies were turning out.
And I feel like
they should have did that from the rip, though.
Deadpool was a big help into introducing the X-Men. Because he had the two lower characters in the last movie and the two movies before this. And now he's got Wolverine in the movie. So I feel like they're using Deadpool to kind of bridge that gap, mm-hmm, to get to X-Men. And
yeah,
if I'm not mistaken, is this the first time they put the TVA in a movie?
Yeah. And especially because it was a Disney thing that they didn't think that they were going to allow them to do that.
Yeah. So I think that...
Yeah, they were only in Loki up to that point.
Yeah, so I think that is a big step, actually. Like, instead of you saying, like, you're saying they're going to chalk it, I think it's a step towards them trying to make sense of it. Like, using the TVA as the middleman for everybody to understand how everybody's traveling through these multiverses and what it means to travel to all these different universes. Mm-hmm. Because that's why I feel like they went through that whole sequence where they kept showing all those Wolverines so they can get an understanding of how you are traveling through this. And then even the reference to Doctor Strange's jaunt that she used to get out of the void, right? It's called the Void. Mm-hmm. To get out of the void and back into their timeline. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's going to be a huge help into understanding, because I feel like I left the theater understanding the multiverse a lot more than before, because a lot of it was starting to get confusing to me.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting, because I feel like it didn't help move it, the needle. Like, I think it feels in the same place that it was. And the reason I say that is because, like, again, it feels like a formula they've done 10,000 times now. You had a villain who started in the beginning of the movie and was dead by the end of it, the Nova John. Mm-hmm. And that felt also unnecessary. Like, make the villain the TVA, and that Deadpool's kind of fighting against the fact that they are still trying to manipulate time and what timelines get to go versus which ones need to be wiped out or whatever. And I think they were trying to frame it through the new lens of Loki kind of running the timeline and letting it be a little bit more organic and letting fate dictate things instead of having like one sacred timeline or whatever. But I just don't think it moved the needle at all. It was more like anything. I took the message as anything could happen in the multiverse.
Mm-hmm. And I think they're using that as like a safety net to bring back all these characters and have all these different scenarios.
Yeah.
And it opens up the possibility to endless movies and endless characters that you could bring up. Like, no matter what situation scenario you're in, they just brought Wolverine back to life and tossed him in a $700 million movie. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. I got a question for y'all, but I'll say this one last thing to that point. I think a couple things happened in the real world that also threw this off for a loop. Like, I think back when they announced the multiverse saga, like, think even before WandaVision came out, right? And you officially were in phase two, mm-hmm. or the next big phase of Marvel, yeah. next saga. I think they had a lot different plans for certain things, and everything from Jonathan Majors with the whole assault thing to Chadwick Boseman dying.
Yeah, that's true too.
To some of the writer strike stuff that kind of delayed production and then had them change production through COVID. Like, there was just so many different things in the real world that I think kind of altered where they were going to go. And then I think they lost their footing. I really do. So I think this whole saga, multiverse, John, is Marvel just trying to regroup and capture their footing, because they know they can't mess up X-Men. They can't mess up Fantastic Four. Mm. So I think they're just going to kind of push all their chips into that.
Yeah.
And this saga, they're just trying to get through it to pump out projects that people will go pay for so that they can still make money. Because, you know, you join the Disney train and that's what happens. You need to produce. You need to make money. I just feel that way because if you really are doing it for the sake of the craft and the artistry of it, I think we would have seen some different moves. Namely, like, you're not going back to the well on these big names, because you would have felt maverick enough and bold enough to go, all right, we're going to get some
right.
nobodies
right.
and build them up into characters like you did with the first saga.
Mm-hmm.
My question to y'all is, if y'all could have done anything differently with Deadpool 1, would you have done it, or do you like it as is? And if you could do anything differently with it, what would you have wanted to see out of this film?
I mean, it's fine the way that it is. I was never a fan of the Deadpool movies. So with that being said, like, I wasn't a fan of I don't find Ryan Reynolds too funny. I don't know. That type of humor never amused me. He had a couple good jokes here or there, but like, for the most part, it was kind of like one-liners and it wasn't too funny. But that's, I feel like, what Deadpool is at its core. All of those movies in the beginning, from the Deadpool 1, 2, and now 3, there was no plot. There was no, like, end game. It was just, this is a bunch of shit happening in a movie.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's been the catalyst. Is that a good word to use for all of his movies? Is just he's going to give the fans what they want. He's going to give you a lot of fanfare as far as a raunchy movie with cursing and dark jokes and cameos from characters. Like, I just feel like that's how it's always been. So with following that Deadpool plot, I feel like it played perfectly to what they always do. But what are you going to do differently? There's nothing that you can do. It's the movie. It's what Deadpool has always been.
I can see that. I feel like if there was anything I would change, it would be add more X-Men elements into it. They had what is his name? Professor X, Wheelchair Bull, his twin sister.
Yeah, that villain chick. Yeah.
Which I never knew was a thing. Was in the movie, and I guess that's a step towards the X-Men, but I don't know. I want to see more of the X-Men characters in these movies, even if it's more cameos, just to push the needle a little bit towards that more. Mm-hmm. I thought it was pretty funny that Deadpool kept telling Wolverine that he's going to be doing this till he's 90, because he's not lying. Mm. They're going to milk that till it's dry.
Yeah.
There's already talks of the Wolverine versus Incredible Hulk movie.
Do we all agree that this Wolverine with Hugh Jackman is going to be in like whatever end, like Avengers 5 or
it's going to stay. Wars, he's going to stay forever.
Yeah, I think.
Yeah.
Knowing where they're going, the fact that they're leading towards the Secret Wars thing, which is like basically a big battle between all the superheroes.
Yeah.
They're going to have this version of Wolverine be in that.
Absolutely. And especially with the de-aging technology they have. Mm-hmm. That's not going to be a problem.
Yeah.
And you've seen they had old Wolverine, mini Wolverine,
yeah,
all types of Wolverines. And this technology nowadays, he is going to be doing this shit till he can't anymore.
Right. Yeah, I even saw at one point they had the Benny Wolverine. Did you see that part?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, I was in there.
4 Timu sweaters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Couldn't bend my arms.
Yeah, and when he went like this, 3 vapes popped out of his hand.
Yo, 3 vape claws is crazy. Yeah, I was thinking about it a little bit. My answer might change to this question, but the one thing that I would have changed to this point that I will, the one point I agree with you, Dev, is that to make it have meaning and purpose, mm-hmm, I would have rather this Deadpool movie be very focused. And the one focus I would have wanted it to have was to introduce whatever timeline has the X-Men in it that we're going to see in the next saga.
Mm.
So, like, you know how they all got those Earth 616, Earth 1005, whatever. Yeah. Whatever the next John is going to be, establish that world so we can see some aspects of it. And just, like, as a preview taste of what that's going to be.
Yeah.
Okay. Because I feel like with the what timeline are we in, and this one's slightly different than that one, it really doesn't have any stakes to it. So to add stakes, I would have been like, it would have been nice to kind of set that stage very prematurely, but go to a genre where there's mutants and you look on the TV and there's like a news broadcast about mutants or whatever. And it's like, all right, we know where we are.
Yeah.
And that's going to be the next arena that we're going to all exist in the MCU.
But that's the thing is this movie seemed like an homage to the whole Fox.
That it was, yeah.
Fox X-Men movies, Deadpool movies. What else was Fox? Fantastic Four movies.
Yeah.
So this seemed like a homage to that. So I think they strictly tried to look at that and just be like, we're going to give them this movie for all the fans of it. And then the next movie that we do, they're going to give us that right there.
Was Fox the one that put out the one with Michael B. Jordan?
Yes.
Yeah, that joint was garbage.
Yeah.
They did that whole montage at the end too during the credits. They showed
Did you watch the after credits, John?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you saw that.
They did like that montage of behind the scenes footage of all the Fox projects. Mm-hmm. Chris Evans made an appearance as Johnny Storm.
Yeah.
Again, another like
the Human Torch.
It was a cool cameo. You know, obviously a big name, but like, did I need that? Sometimes you just don't. I don't want to mess up Cap. Like, he played a perfect Captain America. Just let that live.
But that was cool, though, man. I mean,
yeah,
it was. I was fine with it.
I could have.
And she hit him with the fatality.
Yeah, she did. She did.
That shit was crazy. Slurped
his skin off.
She what?
Slurped his skin off.
Nice. She a freak.
She got the juggers.
Suckers.
She cut the sucker. Nah, but that movie was tough. I mean,
yeah. I wish for me, you know.
Oh, go ahead. No, you're good. You go.
I'll go.
No. No, because I was just gonna like kind of transition and just be like, what was y'all ending score if you had to give it out of a 10 for those who are listening and maybe wanting to see it?
I would give it my meat out of 10.
Spoilers over, ladies and gentlemen.
My meat out of 10.
I just hit a nigga in the head with a ooga booga wooga. That bitch suck my dick, it's all like ooga booga booga.
Meat is not a number.
Yeah, it is. One.
One.
1 inch.
No.
1 inch punch. All right, go ahead.
Give it a 10.
A 10 out of 10? No, it's not a perfect movie. Benny, what would you?
Nah.
No, but that's my meat. A 10. TMI?
You good?
It's a 10 under a magnifying glass.
10 centimeters.
I give it, honestly, I really enjoyed it. Uh-huh. I might go see it again just because it was tough to me. But I give it like an 8.5, honestly.
But bragging on his meat.
I gave it like a 36.
Chambers. 36. Dad, what about you?
I gave it like a 7.5, 7.
That sounds about right.
Yeah. I just couldn't.
Average.
Yeah. So I thought it was average. But it was good though. Again,
yeah.
This is one of the few movies that I was like, I was happy with the chaos and like the nonsense. Yeah. I was happy with like there was no plot, but it gave a lot of cool fight scenes. Probably some of the best fight scenes in Marvel, with the Wolverine and Deadpool fight scenes. At the end,
when they were pretty good.
At the end, well, with the crew that was with them fighting at the end, that whole fight scene was cool.
Yeah.
So 7.5 for me.
I would, in all seriousness, I would give it a 6 out of 10, but with girth.
I used to keep talking about your man's day.
Since we all being honest.
But with girth. But thick.
Girth 616.
But for those who haven't seen it, for those who are curious about it, go ahead and see Deadpool versus Wolverine.
Yeah, if you got a John with the juggas, take her out.
Yep, it's jugga time.
And a couple of your homies.
Yeah, right. Hold on tight to the suckers while you're watching the film.
Hold on tight to the sucker.
It was. It's worth going to.
Yeah,
yeah.
Go see it. It's fanfare.
When was the last Marvel movie that came out?
The Marvels, right?
It's been a minute. Yeah, it might have.
Damn. I thought Madam Web was one of the most recent ones.
Oh, no, we don't claim that.
Yeah, what is that
around these parts?
That's what I'm saying. They fell off crazy, and they needed.
Is Madam Web even in the Marvel? Is in the MCU? I think that's a Sony John.
I think that is a Sony John.
Yeah. We don't acknowledge them.
Yeah, the only Christopher and we acknowledge is Wallace.
Exactly.
We girth. So yeah, go see the movie. Pretty good movie. A lot of action scenes. But Dave, Benny, we're going to do a first. This is a first on the cruise control, y'all. This is the first time we're going to do a blind album review. Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, for those who don't know, not blind, like can't see, but like ear blind. For those who don't know, ear blind.
Deaf?
Yeah, deaf is a thing.
For those who don't know,
I'm ear blind.
Kanye West.
And I like social studies.
Dolla $ign.
Kanye West. And my eyes is raining.
Kanye West and Ty Dolla $ign came out with their second album of the year called Vultures 2.
Ah, dos.
Oh, this is another collab album.
So we did the Vultures one earlier on in the year. We talked about that. We went through some songs. So now we got Vultures 2. So I haven't listened to it yet, you guys.
No.
So, no, I didn't even know this came out.
Yeah, so this came out yesterday. Here's what I'll say about this.
Friday.
Yeah. Yeah, like Friday night. Like, I think late Friday night or something like that.
Yeah.
Here's what I'm going to say. I'm just going off of I'm not gonna play the whole album, obviously, because we don't ever do that on the Cruise Control, but I am gonna play the songs that I like went through Twitter and Instagram, and this is like the songs that pages are posting about. The early reviews is that this is not good. And it's so bad that Kanye West even came out on Instagram and was like, the album's out and I'm also adding more. Stay tuned for like more that I'm going to add to it.
Mm.
So like it seemed like he even acknowledged that he's going to tweak some of these songs and probably even add more songs. So
he put out an incomplete project.
It seemed like it was rushed. It seemed like an incomplete album from what people were saying. So let's just give it a listen. So like I said, I'm going to play y'all a few songs, just what people been talking about. This is the first song on the album. It's called Slide. We were listening to it earlier. Remember that 30 seconds that I played y'all of a song in the beginning of the episode or before we started the episode? That was this song.
All right.
So I'll continue from the part that we stopped, because for those listening in, it's like 30 seconds of this next noise that I'm about to play, that I'm about to play on. So we'll skip all that. But
yeah,
first song on the album called Slide. All right.
Slide.
Nigga, cause I'm wealthy. Back when I was broke, I couldn't find no one to help me. Now it ain't a motherfucking thing that could tell me. Gang got the rhythm, make the ladies go brazy. Dolla got a stroke, make her wanna have my babies. Busy got a baddie on the couch with him right now. Hit that pussy good, I'ma put her on a flight. On site, when I see you, it's on site. When your man ain't loving you right, somebody else will. And I might be that somebody else for real. Tonight, tell her you ain't coming home tonight. And you won't be alone, don't lie. You know I'ma slide, 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 slide.
The beat gotta be tough.
Slide it.
Whenever the beat drop.
Would you ride, baby, would you ride with me? Slide it.
I need a beat drop soon.
Slide it.
I'm turning this song off.
Would you ride, baby, would you ride for me?
She know what I like. Get me in a twilight. Okay. Headed to the high rise. Cruising like eyes wide shut, but I slide in it like a drive-by. The industry don't like me. Tell them pussy niggas likewise.
Okay.
They try to hit me with the side knife.
Okay.
Nice try. If you play with one of my guys, gonna be a homicide twice. We gon' paint the city red as tie-dye, ass tie.
I like the beat.
Addicted to the nightlife. Jumping off a jet skydive. Your life a movie, mine a sci-fi.
Alright, alright. All
right. Told a friend she a 10, I lied. Pretty she in a high five.
What?
Friday.
The initial reaction on people's face. I said, all right, all right. How y'all feeling? Dave was like, like the whole head turn. What's up? What was the head turn for? What was the initial reaction? It seemed, and mind y'all, we had skipped like 30 seconds into the song. Mm-hmm. So that noise that you're hearing in the background when Ty Dolla $ign is singing, that was there the whole 30 seconds before he came on.
Mm.
So just for those who don't know, that's why I didn't play the first 30 seconds, because I didn't want that 30-second nonsense. But why was that your initial reaction, Dave? That face seemed a little bit tired, like this is BS.
I feel like, and I obviously want to hear at least a track or two more, but I feel there's a larger point that I'll make about Kanye later. What I say off of this is I never understood the Ty Dolla $ign love. And I know a lot of people respect him in the industry, the music industry, his contemporaries, other artists. I don't get it. That's one of those to me that I never understood.
Yeah.
Because he's like this sing-songy rapper. So he's like a sing rapper.
Mm.
And it's cool, I guess. It's so many artists that are out now, they make music that sound infinitely better. Mm-hmm. If you drunk or high in the club.
Mm-hmm.
Because you really aren't listening to it.
True.
For substance. It's just a sound. It's like a noise or even like a type of register. Like it kind of rings a certain way in your ear.
Like the frequency.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think that's the word I was looking for.
Okay.
I just don't see it though. If you listen to what is he even talking? I feel like every song Ty Dolla $ign saying the same exact thing.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of Dolla $ign, man. I mean, he's got some great songs.
Shut in and give me top. Shut in and give me top.
He is always talking Shorty, about
top. He's always talking about shorties.
Or you want to talk about bullies?
No. And anything else.
Talk about
Deadpool.
Do you get taxes or something?
Yeah.
How much money you get?
The gubernatorials.
Bandito, yeah. What's up? That's a deep sigh of disbelief. What's going
off of that,
on?
Off of that, I'm going to make a Ty Dolla $ign statement off that first track, and that is, I just don't get the appeal of him.
He go in the parties and stuff. He got some hits though. Come on.
But that's you're just affirming my point that.
No, I know, but I get the appeal. That's his appeal. Is the parties, the clubs. That's his appeal. That's where he goes off at.
But as far as this, like a listening album that I want to sit down and really. Because that's what Kanye has always been, correct? With his beats, with his raps, he's always been that guy that, like, you got to sit down and listen to it, and you enjoy it more.
Maybe I'm in a generation that I'm past this, but Ty Dolla $ign in 15 years, am I going to remember anything he's done?
Hands will make her dance.
Death. 1,000% not Ty Dolla $ign.
Nah, what's the joint that he did? The two bad bitches in the club.
You're going to remember that 15, 20 years from now?
Maybe if they play it at a club or something.
You're going to be like, oh, yeah, that was that one ball. That's how you're going to be in a club.
10 to 15 years from now, I'm going to be like 45. I ain't going to be in no club.
I hope not. You're going to be in the center of the club playing pool.
On my phone.
On your phone. That's crazy.
But nah, the THX sound effect in the beginning of the song.
Oh, there, like at the starting of a movie, right?
Yeah, that was a bad sample choice. And if you a minute and a half into that annoying ass noise when the drums drop, I'm already annoyed. I don't care what the drums sound like. I have no care. As his vocals was clashing with the sound, he wasn't even in the same octave as the sound. It just wasn't good.
Sound engineer right here.
But Benny thinks about it differently because he studied that stuff, you know?
That's what I'm saying. He hears it differently than us, and that's why we need him here.
So not a good start to the album. That's in song number one.
Yeah.
His octaves. All right. The next song.
No octaves.
He like octaves. The next song that I heard from a lot of people was, and this was probably the one song that I heard the most about.
Uh-huh.
It's called Field Trip. This song features who's the boys that was on Carnival again? What's their names? Playboi Carti. I think he's on this song. I think the boy Rich the Kid. I really think he got the same people that was on Carnival to do this drawing. All right, let's play it. It's called Field Trip, okay? Here we go.
This ain't chatter, this quiche.
Double 05, we criminal. Ain't about a yard, about a miss. Tape on the gun, game miss. Tape on it. Shake on it. Shake on it. Shotty key fucking my bones. Moving too fast, about to break some. Shotty key out of my phone. You keep doing that, I'ma break some. Break some.
Who was that? I think that was Cardi. Playboi Carti. I've checked out of the song.
Everybody's on their phones. Benny's on his phone.
Benny's doing a handstand right now. Faking it.
Whipping that bitch like a rental. 200 cash, my bitch say I'm mental. Medical plans, I'm all in the dental. You okay. Like a dog,
hold up.
Fresh out
okay.
The kennel. Niggas say gas,
Travis.
They rolling up fennel. Ain't on my level, of bitch, don't reach. Always hollering about you, bitch, we reach. This ain't no regular chatter, this quiche. You and outside, I wish it was different. You and outside, I wish it was different. Twerking and turk. If that my little bitch, she gon' listen to dirt in the trenches where her been uncomfortable. I was crushing on you, now I'm fucking on you. Instead of busting on you, now you love me. Haters gon' say you just want my little paper, but who am I, nigga? What's
some money. Dick in her stomach, I make her money. The foreign imported from Saudi Arabia. Like how you ride that dick like a gangster. Pray easy, can turn the demon to an angel. My name just should've been tied. Cause dollar signs get what I deal with. Got a bitch high shit out of her mind. Bail on the trip, I done took her to six flat, 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 flat.
How we feeling off that one? Yo, I think that was Don Tolliver, because I just looked up the track list.
Yeah.
Don Tolliver. No. I think he was the one that rapped. That was like flowing on the beat. That was kind of fire.
Yeah. That wasn't Ty? That,
huh?
That wasn't Ty Dolla Sign?
Oh, no. I don't think that was Ty Dolla Sign.
No. He would never.
Yeah, but, I didn't hear Shorty. Wasn't enough shorties for it to be
him. I didn't hear Shorty.
Yeah, he was the boy that was rapping had octaves.
Yeah, they said that's the most played song on the album right now.
Yeah, that, what was that, like 8 bars? That was tough. But outside of that, it's a no from me, dog.
We really not feeling that song, huh?
Yeah, maybe I don't have it in me today, but.
Hey, yo.
Pause. Not interested. That was, it was nothing. It was an ear full of nothingness.
What am I
supposed to like about that?
I don't even
what
know.
What field trip were they on?
To the zoo or something?
To the ecstasy bar?
I don't even know, man.
Target with Benny?
Yeah, that's where I be.
Nah, but for real though, why they be doing field trips to Target though?
Why not? Better question. I'm being honest.
Benny would take his class to Target.
Y'all know what I'm talking about, right?
What are you talking about?
Maybe like five people with their caretaker, and they just be in Target.
Oh yeah,
they got the bag. They try to find some ways to spend it, bro.
They got the bag.
You know where they get that monthly?
I'd be like, y'all couldn't go nowhere else for the field trip.
Sesame that was place. One of them on the hook, bro.
Yo. Pepsi, skip ahead to when I say meat. So we don't get this bull
fired. That's going crazy.
I just be like, yo, take them to a better field trip.
Yeah. But they go to Target.
Don't walk through Walmart.
Telling you, bro. Tap your chest and try to bite your ear. You fit right in.
I wasn't ready for this. I mean, I know I brought up the topic, but I was saying it more from like, I just want them to have better field trips.
Right, I agree.
And
all right, what was this? This was a field trip to hell. Audio hell.
I like the beat. And then whoever was that third person rapping, if it was Ty Dolla Sign or Don Tolliver, whoever it was flowing on that John.
Yeah.
I thought it was, I don't know who that was, but they was flowing real quick. That shit was fire. But that was pretty weak. And then the last song I'm going to play for the team, and then everybody decide if you want to listen to this album or not, Vultures 2. This song is called Fried. And apparently this is, you remember Carnival from the first album? This is Carnival for this album, basically. So this is supposed to be like the hype joint. All right. This is called Fried.
All right.
This is the exact same song. You got the same bulls.
All right.
Just different octaves.
I done had too many friends that died. Sometimes I can't believe I'm still alive. So you ain't had it, but she lied. Boy, don't play with me, you know I'm fried. Boy, don't play with me, you know I'm fried. She giving blowjobs and I applied. She say she starving, order her some fries. Then I ate the breast and the thighs. Then I gave the rest to the guys. You was typing crazy out your mind. This is not a typo, we reply. Now you spilling typo out your side. Boy, don't play with me, you know I'm. Boy, don't play with me, you know I'm bread.
Wow.
pray on our enemies when we die.
Hold on. That's a first.
If you order a meal with breasts and thighs and then you eat the breasts and thighs and give the rest to the guys, what do the guys got?
The sides.
Ain't no suckers left.
That's disgusting.
There's no jiggers left?
No jiggers.
No, don't give me a box full of wedges.
Wedges is tough, though.
Y'all talking about women or food? I'm talking about food.
Yeah.
Like, don't come eat around me. That didn't get y'all riled up.
I mean, when you get two sides, so it's usually a mac and cheese and a wedges, right? What's your sides, Benny?
Double wedges.
Double wedges? You a double wedge boy?
I might double wedge it.
You don't double wedge it. What you doing?
No, like, it depends on where I'm going. If I go to KFC, it's mac and cheese with the fry, with the wedges. If I go to Popeyes, it's double fries.
You know KFC don't even do wedges no more?
Yeah, they
do. Whole nother topic.
They do fries.
I think we should talk about that over this album. Dang. Why don't they do wedges?
That's way more interesting.
Dang, is that...
Where are the wedges?
You feel like this... Now, Dave, the reason I stopped the song is because this is a first on the Cruise Control. Usually, Benny listens. He was like this in the back of the camera. He was the one that announced the cutoff of the song.
As soon as they were like, whoa. Wedges.
Yeah, let's talk about the wedges.
I need wedges.
Double wedges.
How you felt about Carnival Part 2? Because that's basically what it was.
Yeah, this is a snooze fest.
Kanye, this is a snooze fest.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Oh, man. Kanye.
Yeah, I think...
That's my guy, man.
So I said I was going to say a point about Kanye, and that is I get the sense that he is wanting to produce, like, these really artistic and creative projects, which I think is totally fine. I just think he could benefit from removing himself.
Like, oh, so you're saying,
simple as that. Yeah, I think all that, like, if you listen to some of the beats in the production, not bad. You know, obviously you want to find the right artist to fit the sound.
Right.
But in this one, and I will even say Vultures 1, Kanye has felt out of place, like you don't belong on tracks like that. And his rap style and delivery, it just feels like he's kind of forcing himself onto these beats and these sounds.
Mm.
And that to me is what sticks out like a sore thumb. I think that's what's making it not connect.
Mm.
And also forcing this relationship with Ty Dolla $ign, where y'all are like a collab, you know, thing. Like if it was like Drake and The Weeknd or something like that, or like Drake and Future, like it doesn't work.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't.
So do you feel as though he should take more of like a DJ Khaled approach, where he's just the producer on this big album that he got a bunch of artists on?
Yeah, I think that's a fair.
Or like a Metro Boomin, like the way these producers are doing it now.
Take a couple years and just do production.
Yeah, where
it's clear you're having an influence on it. Maybe you do, you know, you speak on the intro, or you people know it's you, but just produce. Like, you don't have to worry about producing lyrical content for it.
Or even a verse or two where you actually saying something, so right, that people look forward to, like, oh, when he speaks, he actually has something to say.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Right now, he don't got nothing to say.
A whole album of breasts and thighs, it's like, we get it, Kanye, you sexual.
Yeah.
And he did that.
That's all his last couple outings have been. Sorry, Deb.
In the beginning of his career, he did that, though, man. And I feel like...
He was talking about way more substance in the early days.
No, what I'm saying is, like, no, not breasts and thighs. I meant, like, producing. Like, he was strictly producing when he started.
Yeah, that's fair.
And he was killing it. He could do that for a whole season. He could do that for a stretch of 3 to 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody would be mad because he's great at producing.
Didn't one of his first produced songs win an award? Like, the John with Scarface, right? And Jay-Z? Didn't he produce one of their songs?
Yeah, I mean, he had a run prior to recording any lyrics.
That he
had a major run.
Yeah.
Jay-Z stuff, State Property stuff, Scarface stuff. Like, he's definitely done some really good production work. And then he obviously wanted to become an artist himself lyrically.
Mm-hmm.
Made that whole career and had that pretty legendary run. Now take a little break. And then maybe in a few years you come back out with some lyrics with a project that really matters to you. But this just feels like, trying to fit an aesthetic or trying to fit in with a certain crowd. Like, I want to show y'all I can make club bangers, strip club Johns. We don't really need that from you.
Right. I'm not feeling this. These three songs right here.
Mm-mm.
And they just feel flat, too, like, energy-wise.
Yeah. When they flew flat, I just.
Yeah.
Right?
I hate when
flee.
I flew flat.
I just flee when I flew flat. Flee, fly, flow, flow.
My bad. Fat tongued it.
Fat tongued is crazy.
Huh? I fat tongued it. Six with girth.
Six with girth.
Too much girth on his flea flung.
Flea, fly, flow, flung.
Y'all are ridiculous.
That's
man.
Crazy.
I just got a master's.
That's true. He's got his master's. Respect to me, smart.
Was respect. A master at Flea Flunger.
Yeah, Flea Flungo.
Nah, this album is trash.
You heard three songs, though. I will say, listen to the album just to give it a good, like a, give it a try. But so far from what I heard, this ain't.
I refuse.
This ain't it, dog.
I'm not convinced.
This ain't it. I will say this, though. Just trying to, you know, get the move the show along. I gotta hop off of this Vultures 2 topic and tell y'all. I gotta tell y'all a little story. All right, I know I'm used to me coming in here and talking to you guys about different bachelor parties or different things at work or this and that, but I recently had this experience where.
Who touched you?
Okay. Where did the
let
angel touch you?
Let me grab a doll
you?
And let me point to where.
Where the angel touched you.
Where were you touched?
So, one of my homies.
Mm-hmm. That means he's white.
One of my friends messaged me the other day, right? And he's like, yo, Dev, listen, I'm talking to this girl. And this is the first time that I've ever done this in the relationship or like with talking to somebody. Mm-hmm. But like the girl wants me to meet like one of her best friends. He said, in my past two relationships, I never met their friends. It was just like school and work and everything that we never really got a chance to meet friends.
Okay.
So he was like, this is the first time I'm doing it. Like, do you mind taking some time out of your day and hanging out? So I was like, of course. Like, you're my brother. I'll be there for you. Like, I'll meet her and talk, whatever. So this joint was like at 11 at night that they wanted to hang out. These joints wanted to hang out. I'm like, it's sleepy time, right? Correct. It's time to sleep. So he was really pushing for me to go. So I did it. I got out of my comfort zone. I dressed up, went out to this to meet these girls, right? Before we head into the bar, he's like, look, let me talk to you a little bit about the girl that I'm talking to. Never met her friend before. This is the first time ever. Like, she's mentioned her a couple times, but I never met her. But this is okay. About my friend. How do I approach things? So we start going over things, kind of come up with a plan or whatever, just in case, whatever. So we walk in, say what's up to the girl, say what's up to the friend, sit down at the tables, start ordering drinks, start eating food. And then the friend takes over. And this had to be
the friend of the girl.
The friend of the girl takes over. And this had to be the weirdest outing that I've been to in a while.
Mm-hmm.
But like, when I mean like, the personality was just too much. So first off, like this John, let me give you an example. We start talking about jobs, right? Obviously, first time meeting people, jobs usually tend to come up. Where do you work? What do you do? Where'd you go to college? Whatever. That's a normal thing, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So she's like, oh yeah, I own a funeral home. So I'm like, all right, cool. That's what's up. Like, how'd you get along that? I went to funeral school. I was like, oh, all right, that's what's up. Yeah, like I had to learn like this and that at funeral school, and I had to see dead bodies, and COVID, we was making a lot of money, and I loved COVID because that's where I made my most cash at. And you know, we had bodies stacked up to the ceiling. We had so many bodies that I had to go to Walmart and I had to go to Home Depot and buy a platform so I could stack the bodies up on the platforms. I've been going to New York, to LA, to this, to do all these bodies. Like, yeah, I just love, like, when it's a funeral time, I got money in my pocket, so I'm cool off of that. Like, and the more I think about funerals, the more I think cha-ching, because that's where my money comes from. And I had to leave college because I had to go to a funeral. I'm like, shut the fuck up. Like, nonstop talking about funerals. Like, mind you, we try and meet people, like we trying to greet, we trying to meet each other, talk about friends and family and all that other stuff. And all this was the whole time. The whole time.
The friend was Wednesday Adams?
Yo, straight Wednesday time, like
Jenny Ortega.
She's straight Jenny Ortega.
Right.
Then, that's not even the worst part, y'all. I order a drink, right? So They gave me my drink. I stir it up, start sipping on the drink. Drink is okay. It's not horrible, but it's not like a good, like the best drink I ever had, right?
What was the drink called? A dirty funeral?
Did you order a cannoli cruise?
No, the drink was like a blackberry, like John, like a, I don't know, a flavored blackberry drink. Mm. So I start drinking it. I'm like, she notices me sipping on the drink. So she's like, what's wrong with your drink? I'm like, oh, nothing. It's chilling. Like, I'm just sipping on it right now. I'm going to order another one after this, but it's chilling. Oh, you don't like your drink? No, I'm cool. But I'm just sipping on my, excuse me, waitress. Like, I'm like, yo, what are you doing? So she calls the waitress over. So the waitress comes over. Hey, is everything okay? He doesn't like his drink. Takes the drink out of, like, if I had the drink like this and I was holding it, takes the drink out of my hand and hands it to the waitress. He doesn't like his drink. Can you take it away? And I'm like, and I look at my homie. He's like, got his head in his hand. I'm like, so then the waitress is like, oh, if you didn't want the drink, honey, like, you could have just said you didn't want the drink. Like, you know, it's okay if you don't like it. I'm like, no, it's cool. I'm like, can I get the drink back? The girl's like, no, don't. He don't want that drink. I'm like, yo, who is this joint? you killing everything right now.
Yeah.
So then the waitress is like, all right, well, I'm gonna take this drink off your bill. What drink do you want? And I'm like, well, I didn't look at the menu because I wasn't planning on giving up my drink. But can you come back and I'll look at the menu and see what type of drink I want? Oh, sure, don't worry about it. I'll take this off and then I'll come right back, see what type of drink you want. So then the waitress leaves. She's like, I'm sorry if you don't like me or if you don't think that was cool. But you didn't like your drink, and I don't like to see people waste their money on drinks, so I'm just going to go ahead and do it for you, if that's okay. I'm like, what you want me to do? You did that shit already. Like, you want me to throw my drink at you? Like, right. What did you expect to happen from this? So just through the whole vibe, and then the...
Was she buying the drink?
No, my homie paid for it. He was paying... He wanted to do this, like, as a... He paid for me because I came out and supported, and then he was going to pay for the girl. So he's like, Dev, it's all on me tonight, whatever. I'm going to take care of it, whatever. Get a drink, get food.
I'm annoyed just listening to this story.
Yeah.
So then, right, the girl, my homie's girl that he was talking to, she's silent the whole time, not saying nothing, chiming in here or there. And so is he. And I know his vibe. If he's not feeling a good vibe, he won't say nothing.
Yeah.
Like, because he doesn't want to talk. Like, he's like, what am I going to say? Like, this is weird.
Right.
So he's really quiet most of the time. Like, he talks in pieces, bits and pieces or whatever, but he's not really saying. But so this whole time it's just me having, like, laughing because I'm thinking about this joint just being weird. Like, she talked about funerals for like 45 minutes. Like, what type of time you on? Yeah. Like, I'm like, what is going on? So the funniest part of this whole night, right, the bill comes, we eat food,
mm-hmm.
pay for the bill, we're walking out, right? So we're walking out and we get to the my friend's like, I'll drive y'all home to the girls. Mm-hmm. So the one girl's like, bet you can't beat me to the car. And I'm like, thinking to myself, what? So then the funeral friend tells the other friend.
She's trying to race
like midnight in a parking lot.
Like foot race.
So she puts her drink and her phone in my chest. So she's like next to me. She goes and hits me in the chest. And like, I'm like, and she's like, 3, 2, 1, go. And these two grown women in the middle of the night hauling ass, like, like running hard as shit in the parking lot.
Shikari Richardson
to the car. Like, running to the car. I didn't even see who won. But at that moment, when they ran, my homie looked at me. He was like,
y'all should have ran the opposite way.
My homie looked at me. He was like, it's a wrap. He was like,
I'm like Benny. Cut it.
He said, cut it. Put the volume down on the Johns. They said, I can't anymore with this. And then he gave me an update of the story afterwards and basically was like, the girl that he was talking to was like, you were too quiet during our outing and like it threw me off. So I'm really thinking about where we are right now. And I'm really thinking about if I want to continue this mm-hmm. relationship. So he reached out to me, kind of hit me onto what was going on. And I was like, she got a weak spirit. I think you should talk her. I was like, her friend was weak and she was weak for saying that you were silent because she was silent too.
Yeah.
So I was like, she clearly caught the vibe of her friend drawling because she wasn't saying much during that thing.
Mm-hmm.
But she want to blame it on you. So I was like, just chalk it. I was like, it don't hurt you none.
Yeah.
Who cares? So long story short, it was chalked. And when I asked him, like, what did he say to the John? His reply was, your friend is weak.
Yeah.
Really?
Your friend weak.
So, like, your friend threw me off.
Your friend threw me off. Your friends, which I agree with him on this, your friends are you. Your best friends, the people that you consider, like, real close to you, this is what we were told. Mm-hmm. That's a piece of you. That's a person who you're going to have around a lot.
It's like a reflection of.
Going to be in your wedding. They're going to be around your kids, your husband, your wife, whatever the case may be. They're going to be around. So if that's who you decide to bring around, your peoples and all that, I have to take that into consideration. And she's weak. And you don't want to talk to me because she was weak and she ruined the night. And that's on you. So it's over. And it's been chalked. So I say that story to give you guys the question of the week. And to our controllers out there who are listening, please chime in. Once you like and subscribe, you can go ahead and comment underneath the video below. Will a friend be a reason that you chalk a potential relationship? Could your friend possibly ruin a relationship for you? Mind you the story. Mind you what I just told you. First time meeting. You meet this friend weak.
But like, what if they thought you was weak?
The friend?
Yeah. Like, you don't got no spine. You can't reorder your drink that you clearly hated.
Well, I wasn't talking to the John. Why are you talking to me for? How he switched this up on me?
Too much chest.
Too much chest. You just walked in the bar.
Chest first.
Breaking the door.
I walked in on my chest.
Walked in on your nipples.
She pulled the drink out your chest, handed it back to the waiter.
I had the drink here and drinking out the straw.
Like, you and don't race.
It was testing y'all to see if y'all would join the foot race.
Yeah.
Y'all was weak for not joining the foot race.
You and your homie don't race.
You would have foot raced?
No.
What you would have did, Benny, as soon as they start racing?
I walked away. Left the stuff on the ground.
Your car was right there, though.
Like, you're right here. I'm gonna see y'all.
This is a complicated question because it's like, yes, I think everybody's entitled to feel how they feel about other friends, but they have a perspective as well. And I think that has to be acknowledged and respected.
Right.
Like, they might have looked at y'all as collectively corny because you didn't jump into what they're interested in. And like, if the friend truly was like a funeral director or whatever, that's her life. And like, if y'all didn't take interest in it, it kind of is a reflection of y'all and y'all's care and investment in them. So could the answer really just be there wasn't a vibe? There isn't a natural connection.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, it makes sense that y'all would chalk it, but it also makes sense that they would, that it all, it could also make sense that they would want to chalk it. Like, again,
okay,
y'all needed to jump in the race. At that point, it needed to become a wheelbarrow race.
Would you would have raced?
Huh?
Would you would have raced?
Hell no.
I think you barely.
I'm not running for nobody. But then, you know, that's something I know about myself. At the same time,
but isn't
there's a bunch of wacky races out here?
Wacky race. Nah, here's my question to y'all. I keep it a beam with yourselves though. Like, isn't it your duty? And I think this is true. It's your duty as a best friend to realize who your friends are, right? It's you. Like, all right, Benny, say you got a homie who's like mad loud. He just everywhere y'all go, yo, what's up? Like, when you go out with your family, with your girl, whatever, you know in your mind, like, yo, if I bring Boy out, if I bring Julio out, he might be drawling. He might be screaming and being mad loud. Maybe I don't invite him to this party. Maybe I invite somebody else. Isn't that on you as a friend to do that? Don't you realize that about your friends? Doesn't that say something about you?
But it says something about you regardless because, oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Yes, dude. No, I'm just like, your friend is your friend. if that's her best friend, she's not going to pick a different friend. You're eventually going to meet that best friend.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it is a reflection of her. She likes the funeral, John. That's her. That she likes the racer. That's her friend. Yeah. She's you're going to meet her eventually. So is you shouldn't try to hide it just because you're trying to help your friend bag or whatever. You're trying to, you know, bag whatever.
What if they do that every Friday?
Race and talk about funerals?
Go to the bar and race to the car.
Race to the hearse.
Yeah. First one to the hearse wins.
She drove a hearse to the to the date. I really live for this.
Yeah.
Drove her. You don't like your drink? Here, try this embalming fluid. It's yummy.
It's to die for. Yeah, bro, it was mad weird. But what do you, Zach, also on some serious note, though, on some serious stuff?
It's possible, yeah. It's possible that somebody's friend could ruin your perception of a person you're interested in.
Would you do that?
It could be, yeah.
Like how my friend did, would you do the same thing?
I think I would. I think,
would you make an excuse, though? You could be like, nah, like, I'm sick or, like, I got homework, so I'm not going to be able to talk to you anymore.
That's a good question.
Or would you just be like, your friend weak? In my opinion...
Respectfully. I wouldn't divulge that. Me personally, I wouldn't, because I don't be trying to hurt people's feelings or yuck their yum. Mm-hmm. Again, like for me, I would have understood, okay, that's your friend. That means you value them for whatever XYZ reasons. Mm-hmm. Because they are a reflection of you, and because I know that that's not my wave, like we not on the same wavelength, I'm going to just chalk the whole thing, but I'm not going to make it to seem like there's something wrong with y'all. It's just not a connection for me. It's not a match for me. So I would probably, you know, kind of become distant or tail off a little bit. And if they say, hey, I just feel like, you know, you're not as talkative as you used to be, or it doesn't seem like you're interested in, then you could just hit with a more generic, like, yeah, I just see us going in different directions, or, you know, I don't feel like the spark is there, blah, blah. I wouldn't be like, your friend is insufferable, because that's not fair to them necessarily. Like, they'll find two people one day that will race with them.
Two bulls. Wow, these girls are crazy.
Just start. Bet you can't beat me to the car. And they were like, bet you can't beat us. Race you to the funeral home. And they'd be like, oh my God, these guys are incredible.
You found
the heaven one. Sent.
Oh yeah, and side note. Shit, these friends met through an app. Like, they met on a best friends app for people who were searching for best friends.
They have those?
Yeah. Bumble has an app. Bumble has it so where you could look for a man, you could look for a woman, you could look for non-binary or whatever, and they have one where you can look for a friend.
So you could make friends on the app.
Yeah. They have like four different sections to the app that you can
make friends in real life.
That's true.
So Racer X97 and matched with Funeral Lover 69.
Death by Chocolate.
I guess.
Benny's sick. He wasn't even there. He got a headache.
I mean, yeah, what's your take on this? Like, can a friend ruin your vibe with the person you're interested in?
Yeah, absolutely.
You ever did that, Benny? You ever like told somebody that it's a rap, but all in all it was because of a friend?
Nah, I've never chalked somebody because of a friend. But I do feel as though, like we said a little bit earlier, like people are a product of their environments. And like you said, if they're a reflection of you to a certain extent. And sometimes people are polar opposites, and which allows them to get along, like the yin to the yang thing, that whole whatever. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we're not foot racing to the car after a few drinks. That's just not happening. And I'm not going to shit on them for being different, but I'm also the type that I cut people off quick when the vibes ain't right. Mm. And I won't cut them off the moment the vibes ain't right, but the moment the vibes ain't right, I'll start assessing it, and then I pick the cutoff date, and then you chalked.
The cutoff date is crazy.
Yeah. Because there's only like...
when the vibes ain't right.
Yeah.
Because the moment the vibes ain't right, you know what I realized? The vibes ain't right.
The vibes ain't right.
Yeah, then you got to find the cutoff date. And you got...
and you got to find the vibe.
Yeah.
That is right.
If the vibe ain't there, what we doing?
Right.
Yeah. You and the person, like... you and the person you're dating, and then by extension their friends, y'all gotta be on the same octave.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Girth.
Yeah, like, what's your octave in girth? Like, is that on the app? Octave and girth?
Yeah, it's like, it's your height, your weight, your girth, and your octave. It tells you to get your different...
that's so important.
Stats out there.
You know?
When I used to have them dating apps, that was my bio.
What was it?
Six with girth.
Six with girth, C minor. This is octave.
Yo, that's crazy. Six with girth. Yo, that's crazy for an app to add.
I feel like you missed the opportunity, though, to have fun with that, too. Like, you could have just been equally as insufferable and have an insufferable off.
What should I have said, though?
Like, see who could be the worst, corniest friend.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's true. I could have. Should I have said, like, I'm a religious, like, person or something like that? Kind of like.
Should have started laughing like Woody Woodpecker.
That would have been crazy.
Then you should have pulled out one of them finger skateboards and start doing it over everything. I wish you had a kickflip onto my new drink.
Onto my new drink. Thanks, girl. I love my new drink. You make me so happy.
And then you should have been like, cat got your nose. You should have took the friend nose.
I should like this. I had a flower that I pressed.
Yo, that's such a funny... that's such a funny premise, yo. Just be prepared. See, that's a great wingman right there. When you come prepared to possibly match the level of...
match my freak.
to match the level of potential corniness you might experience in the other thing. Because you were essentially playing wingman.
Yeah, that's true.
And you wasn't with it either. Like, you just wasn't having it.
Well, like, I was... so, because I talked about my friend's, like, point of view on this whole thing.
Were they bad?
No. In my humble opinion.
Big meaty claws.
In my humble opinion. Again, I'm not going to yuck my friend's yum because obviously he was taking his one girl on dates. So just not my type. But,
yeah.
You know, everybody got their own type. So it really don't matter. They had good hygiene. They had nice teeth. Actually, no, the one John had braces. They didn't even have nice teeth.
She was working her way towards nice teeth.
Yeah. She was getting close.
Any juggers?
Yes. That was, okay, that was there. From the both.
Okay.
Yeah. It was Jugga City.
Yeah.
Two pairs of suckers?
Yeah.
There was a Jugga race to the car.
Yeah, that was, yeah.
Let me stand in the front of the race. Stand at the finish line.
Let me be the flag. Race to me, ladies. It was a Jugga race. Yo, man.
It's totally possible, Dev. It really is.
Mm-hmm.
But to each their own, man. There's a racer out there for everybody.
Racer X. Mm-hmm.
And don't... I would say if you've ever been in a situation, if you're listening, where you feel like you were the friend that kind of turned somebody else off that one of your best friends was dating,
mm-hmm.
or if you've experienced, you know, I just think, look, it's too many fish in the sea. It's like 9 billion people in this world.
There's too many.
Just keep it pushing.
There's a lot of racers in the marathon. You feel me?
Exactly.
Like, yeah. There's a lot of bodies in the casket.
There, you know what I'm saying? There's so many options out there. Just keep it pushing. But there's no need to ever belittle somebody else for what they do. And who they are, just, you know, let it be what it is. Y'all, that's not y'all's vibe.
Yeah.
And it's not theirs. And that's okay.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is episode 119. Ah! here on the Cruise Control. Like we say all the time, please like, comment, and subscribe right here, right under the Dave Pepsi can sign. Like, comment, and subscribe. Follow us on all the socials. Follow us on the TikTok, on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, at the Cruise Control Show. You already know what it is. Dave, you got a song lined up for us? You got something fire to cleanse us of this Vultures 2 album that we just heard? Okay. I'm feeling that.
Dave, where can the people follow us?
You can follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, YouTube, at the Cruise Control Show.
Follow Benny
in real life.
Follow me on Bumble.
What's your Bumble name on Bumble Best Friends?
At Jugamaster. Sign a check for your hoe. Jigga style is love. X and O. Juggernaut. Call me the Juggernaut.
Found it.
Like, no, all seriousness. Follow me on Bumble, 6 foot Girth.
Yo, that's not your bank account. We gonna name that the title.
Damn near out the rear truck. Follow Dev, 2 weeks till I close up. It's all basic. Huh? Too skinny. Been 100 since they had small faces. Yeah. Rob your stash out, doubled out down.
2 inches. Got it locked. 2 inches skinny.
Who no girth. Switching full lanes. Top down. Girthless.
Oh man.
We love you guys. Thank you for listening in episode 119. The Juggernauts are out.
Put it down hard for my dogs that's locked in the thing. When you hit the bricks, new whip, money ain't a thing. Y'all wanna floss with us?
I wanna take things slow.